Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for July to September 2016. La Nina remains on the cards, but it's unlikely to be as strong as a 2010-12 event. The strongest driver of Australia's climate in 2016 is likely to be the Indian Ocean, which is fueling the chance of a wetter and cooler year than 2015. First, let's look at recent conditions. Two east coast lows formed in June, carrying extra moisture from a record warm Tasman Sea. These brought significant rainfall to dry areas in the north of the Murray-Darling Basin, Western Queensland and Tasmania. For instance, Longreach had more rain this June than it received in all of 2015 or 2014. Tasmania, which had its driest 10 months on record to April, then had its second wettest May-June period in 117 years of records. These rains mean areas of rainfall deficiency have reduced. In Tasmania, for instance, 14-month deficiencies accumulated since May 2015 have all but disappeared. Lower layer soil moisture is now higher than average across most of inland Australia and Tasmania. Since May, water storages in the Murray-Darling Basin, southwest Australia and Tasmania have all risen. Maximum temperatures across northern Australia were at record high levels in June. Bradshaw in the Northern Territory set a new national record for the warmest June day, 37.9 degrees on the 7th of June. Nights also broke temperature records in the north. Troughton Island of Western Australia broke the national record for highest minimum temperature in June, five nights in a row, only getting down to 27.9 degrees. And Darwin had its latest first night of the year below 20 degrees on record on the 21st of June. Northern Territory mango growers still haven't had the five nights below 20 degrees they need for good flowering. So what's driving Australia's climate right now? The Indian Ocean is shaping up to be the strongest influence on our weather this winter and spring. Warm sea surface temperatures south of Indonesia and easing of temperatures off Africa mean a negative Indian Ocean dipole, or IOD, is looking increasingly likely. This typically increases rainfall in central and eastern Australia. In the Pacific Ocean, El Niño ended quickly. Most indicators have now moved towards La Niña, except for the trade winds in the tropical Pacific, which have yet to become stronger than normal. The chance of La Niña this year remains around 50%, which is double the normal odds. So our ENSO outlook is still at La Niña watch. If we do have a La Niña in 2016, our models show it is unlikely to be as strong as the last La Niña from 2010 to 2012. So what's the rainfall outlook for July to September? Above average rainfall is likely across most of Australia, especially in the southeast. Outlook accuracy is moderate at this time of year. Turning to stream flows, by the end of May, flows were already returning to more average conditions, with near median or high flows forecast for two-thirds of locations. We're still analysing data from the heavy rainfall in June for our next seasonal streamflow forecast, which will be available on the 11th of July at bomb.gov.au/water/SSF. Turning now to temperature. Outlooks suggest days will continue warmer than average across the far north and in Tasmania, but cooler than average for the rest of the country. Nights are also looking warmer than average across the north, in Tasmania and in eastern Victoria. Accuracy for this outlook is moderate at this time of year. So in summary, we're watching for La Niña, but expect the Indian Ocean dipole to dominate our climate for the coming months. Odds favour above average rainfall for most of Australia, with temperatures warmer than average across the north and in Tasmania, but cooler elsewhere. For more details, head to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 28th of July. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Paul Feikema.